Now, there are a lot of ways to get through life, and not all of them are ideal. The words mom and overwhelm are just so connected that being overwhelmed is almost like an expectation. And that's just considered normal, I guess. But overwhelm isn't a feeling that we should experience persistently as we're navigating life. So if you're overwhelmed and you know it, you don't want to exist in such a negative state as you go through your life as a mom, right? Well, if so, if that's how you're feeling, then you're in good company, because Crunchy SuperMom is all about building a community of open-minded and like-minded moms who just don't believe that the image of SuperMom is the one that society has tried to paint, right? If you have an ideal vision of what SuperMom should be in your mind, then if you were to compare it to what society says is the perfect mom, would they add up? Would it be similar? It really shouldn't be similar, because the expectations that society puts on women today is they're just completely unrealistic. And not to mention, so what if your focus isn't on being, you know, the thinnest, the youngest, the most wrinkle-free mom who makes it on time to every single soccer game and brings all the handmade brownies with all that stuff? You know, if that is not your goal for your life, then that doesn't make you anything less than the perfect mom for your family, the perfect wife for your household, because, you know, society just has these unrealistic things set up. And if we start creating our vision for ourselves using these recommendations that society sets up, we're gonna find ourselves being really dissatisfied. Now, if you're just kind of creating these ideals because of society and you can't shake them, you are just negative, use a lot of negative self-talk to tell yourself that it's your fault that you are not achieving these ideals that you think are realistic, I encourage you to read some books, because there is a lot of personal development that moms need to do, myself included. I've done a lot of personal growth throughout the last few years, especially because I started to realize that the things we put into our mind and into our hearts, those are the things that we speak to ourselves. And you've probably heard me say this if you've been around Crunchy SuperMom for any length of time. If you wouldn't say something to your child, or you wouldn't allow someone to say it to your child, would you say it to yourself? Like, why do you say it to yourself? So many of us beat ourselves up with words and our thoughts that it's ridiculous. And it's not our fault. I'm not saying that you should just like shake that habit, because there's a lot more that goes into it than that, and it's a process. And sometimes it involves healing past trauma and relationships and just things like that. So it's a very, very deep thing. And that's why I believe so much in the Crunchy SuperMom community, because while I give you lots of tips and tools, I also focus a lot on mindset and belief in ourselves and just positive self-talk. Because I've been a mom just like the rest of us that talks poorly to myself. Like, I speak unkindly to myself and just saying like, oh, if you could just do this, or if you could just do that better, you would just be a better mom. And I've noticed that in the last 8 or so years, I have stopped doing that. I actually think highly of myself, and not because I don't think of myself as being better than other people, but I think highly of myself in that, you know what, these are reasonable expectations I'm placing on myself, and today things are not going as I had planned or as I had hoped, but that doesn't make me a bad mom. I'm not failing today. I'm just gonna reframe, and I'm going to figure out how to make tomorrow better, or do I really need to do the things that I think that I need to do today, right now, in order for everyone to be happy and satisfied and comfortable? And sometimes having a bad day just happens and has nothing to do with me. And sometimes it does have everything to do with me. I mean, how many times have we woken up just feeling like not doing anything or being productive, right? That's a normal thing. So let's figure out, because I'm all about the mindset thing, but I also know that having an action plan is a great way to get out of a funk. So let's figure out how to rock motherhood like a supermom with 5 easy steps, okay? The first one is to define what supermom really means to you. You need to scrub your ears, your eyes, and your mind of all those negative thoughts that tell you to hang up your cape. Hanging up your cape will result in only one thing: more overwhelm and more dissatisfaction. And what I mean by hanging up your cape, it's that thing where people say, oh, the dishes can wait, oh, the kids come first, oh, you don't have to have a clean house. That's true, we don't. But if you are a supermom like I am, then you're the type of person who thinks better when your house is clean. You feel calmer when there's not clutter around you, and When you know that your meals are planned and your family's eating nutritiously, you feel a lot more relaxed. It's not even, some people think that that's a control thing, but it's really not. It's just a personality type that has a high level of achievement. We have a high drive to do things, and we can do them. We just have to do them in a way that is healthy, balanced, organized, and just happy, right? We can't be doing it as if it's like our laborious job that we just have to slave away and do it no matter how unhappy we feel. That is not the case. So if hanging up your cape allows you to achieve your greatest goals in life, then hang it up. Keep a dirty house. Don't do the dishes. If that makes you happy, then do it. But define what Supermom means to you, and without allowing any outside influence to alter your vision. And that includes me. So the things that I say are important to me whenever I share them here with you, those do not need to be things that you adopt, okay? It has to be your vision without any outside influence. And then step number two is to accept limitations. Your beliefs limit and push you the most. If you don't believe in yourself and your ability to reach your goals, then you're right. You can't be a super mom. You can't achieve the things that make you excited. If that fires you up and makes you want to argue with me, good. What you think about, you bring about. So you need to put your mind toward achieving those goals and believing in yourself. That doesn't mean that you're gonna practice crafts until you match what you found on Pinterest necessarily, unless that's what you wanna do. You're not gonna rip out a Martha Stewart scene and create it in your home and share it all over social media as evidence that you made it, you're finally a super mom, right? No, that's not a super mom. That's the exact icon we want you to reject, because the true super mom is one who strives for her own ideal, for no other gratification except internal gratification. And also, some of us are driven to make our families happy, right? And I tell my kids this all the time. If you, because we talk about money and having things and like why that's not something that everybody needs to strive for. And I tell my kids, like, would, if you had all the money in the world, there would be really nothing to work for, but you could make things for people or buy things for people or do things for people that would bring them joy. And it wouldn't have to be elaborate, but just bringing other people joy can be really, really satisfying. And what I have found is that a lot of crunchy supermoms share that making their family happy, and not in the buy my kids Disney every year kind of happy, but just like the simple things, like seeing joy on their face and things like that. That's the kind of thing that we all strive for. And sometimes that comes with money, and a lot of times it doesn't. It comes with just having time. Time is the most rare commodity that we have, and it's one of the most important ones. And it's actually a currency that children prefer, maybe not teenagers, but I know right now up to age 11, time is still the most important currency that I can give to my children. So just keep that in mind. There's just a lot of satisfaction in being a happy mom so that you can have a happy household. Now, there's just really no greater feeling than sitting on a perfectly clean couch, listening to your children playing, and hearing the oven ding that your homemade dinner is ready. Maybe you don't share that same sentiment, but that's how I feel. And that moment can't really be captured and pinned, right? You can't put it on Pinterest. It belongs in your mind and in your heart, and as a sign that you are doing it, you're living your best life, the ideal supermom life that you've designed. So, step three, compare yourself to your ideal self. Comparison is a tool straight from the devil. It truly is. However, comparing yourself to your ideal self is a different exercise, okay? In this exercise, you're looking at your life and you're making a list of the things you are doing well and the things you aren't doing well, and or at least to the best of your ability. Highlight the most painful things so you can work on those first. This might be something as simple as keeping your house cleaner, or it may be as complex as reducing the yelling in your home, which is something that I am feeling as my child reaches teens, the teen years. Yeah, that is a really challenging time. So that is something that's on my focus list as something that is not part of my ideal vision for myself, is to enter into power struggles with my preteen. It's quite a challenge, right? So step number four is to make an action plan, which I know we're going through an action plan, but this is step four. You need to identify those areas of improvement and make a plan to work on just one of those areas. This is where you'll reap the most benefits by joining our community of supermoms, because we have a diverse group of moms who know they are capable of supermom status and they're actively working on it every single day. You know, one small bite at a time is how we achieve our goals. And you can share this action plan with us and we'll help you get on track for achieving your ideal lifestyle. So along those same lines would be step number 5, find support. Not everyone loves the idea of you being a super mom, especially if you start making big changes in your life, and that's okay. That's why you need to find a group of like-minded moms, which is our community is a great place for that. And they might not live near you, but they totally get you. And I can't help but recommend our hand-picked group of super moms because we all live everywhere, globally actually, and we all share similar goals in life, but very few of us actually share the exact same goals, right? So I hope this was helpful for you. I would love to see your action plan and see how I could help with any of it. And there are a lot of resources at crunchysupermom.com that focus on all these different areas that might end up on your area for improvement, from cleaning your house better to making healthy meals to just managing your time in a better way. If you want to check out any of that, go to crunchysupermom.com/latest to find out my latest freebie, my newest workshops and things like that can help you get in the path, get in action toward being the supermom that you hope to be.